Hi, this is Marcus. We are going to create a beautiful black and white photo out of this image right here inside of Capture 120. One of the guidelines I use for creating black and white, or what drives me to do a black and white, is if I have a photo that has a lot of different variations of colors and the colors just doesn't mesh. You can see this was a very warm day. And you can see the sun and the effects that the sun has actually happened. And there's a lot of different variations of colors. Now, I could keep this in color and do a good job, and I could take it into Photoshop and do some things with the sky and those kind of things there. But if you just look at the colors and then you see what's reflecting on the water, it's not very good flattering colors. And so when I have something like that, they're perfect candidates for black and white. So what I'm going to do is right click here, and we're going to create what we call a clone variant. And what that would allow me to do is, when I create this clone variant, you can see when I click this here, it actually tells me that this is the second copy of it. I can see it's got the number 2 there, and I'm going to have all of the same flexibilities, but I'm going to be able to, if I wanted to, go ahead and do this one in color and do this in black and white. I can do that without, you know, having to reset the file or do anything differently to it. So let's just go ahead and get started. So the first thing you want to do with this is, when you come into Capture One, now I have the loop tool set to 100. For those of you that don't know what that is, you go under this bar here and you can set the size. I have it set to large. I can also go up to 200%. So if I do 200, that will let me see more details. And I think I'm going to keep it on 200. This is one of the features that used to be inside of the Apple application called Aperture. And I just love that Capture One has brought that over. So we have that. So the first thing I'm going to do is, I'm going to go into the lens, and we're going to start correcting whatever the issues with the lens. Now, I shot this with a 35mm f2, which was a Canon. This was shot with a 5D Mark IV. And for some strange reason, Capture One does not have the lens profile for that lens. And that 35mm lens, the EF version, the F2 with the stabilization, is probably the best, other than the RF lens that they've created for the Canon, the best 35mm lens that they make, right? The F2 has a nice bokeh with it. It's not as fast as F1.4, but it has stabilization, so you can get those, you know, those real low shutter shots, but they don't have that. So fortunately, this doesn't look like it's got anything distorted at the point where I need to correct it manually. So we're just going to go ahead and leave it like that. Now, there is some, there's vignetting, but like, if I bring this up, but it's not going to give me the vignetting that I would want to do. So I can take that off, but I think I'm doing more damage, because it's not really, it's not doing anything with the lens profile. I have a generic profile. I can click this and say analyze and see if there's any chromatic aberration. I'm not worried about diffraction, because we're not shooting at a high enough aperture to have that kick in. I'm going to have this just do a generic thing and look at the photo and try to bring in the sharpness. And we're not going to go 100%, nowhere near that. If I start doing the distortion, you can see it starts doing things. And I don't know if it's really, I'm looking at it, we'll keep it around 9%. That's fine. But actually, I like it at 0, because it doesn't do anything to me that I think. And there's no fringing, because I'm going to create this into black and white. So, and it's been cropped. I cropped this to a 4.5. So that's what I want to be able to do with that. If I click this right here, this will show you how much room we had. But I want it to be a 4.5 again, because it makes it more interesting. So let's go ahead and hit the P key, and we'll go back to this. Now, the next thing that I'm going to do with this is, when we go into here, is using the auto curve. So for instance, if you go to add to lift up shadows, you can see those shadows being lifted. You can also go to high contrast, but the reason why I wouldn't go to high contrast, sure, it brings in the blacks, but it actually amplifies the whites as well, and it just makes the job a little bit more difficult. So here, if I choose linear response, you can see what it does for me. If I choose that, that actually looks pretty good. Now, what I'm concerned with, if this was going to be color, is how it dingied up the whiteness of the sweater, right? Because if I take that back off and put it back on auto, you can see, but those are really colors that are just really blown out. If I go back into here to see what it's doing, and I brought down the highlights, you can see that's about the color anyway, right? So if I did that, and then went back to this and did linear response. That gives me a much flattering photo. It's flatter, it's going to allow me, we're gonna go ahead and choose that curve of that, right? Because again, now if I wanna warm this up, this is already a warm photo. I'm gonna do all the things that I need to do to this photo as far as moving curves. I'm not too much worried about the colors because I'm gonna convert it to black and white, so or monochrome. So when we go back into here, I'm looking at, I brought down the highlights and that looks pretty good. We're gonna stay on the luma curve and those different things right there. I'm looking at the different shadows and things right here. So I don't have to play with the, what we're gonna do right now is we're gonna go ahead and convert this to a black and white. So we're gonna click this right here. And this is going to enable me to enable that. So we have that enabled. And we have the exposures and things that we need to have right on this right here. So I'm looking at this here. And the red is pretty much going to be with the skin. And it's going to be with the hair because she's a redhead. So we're going to bring up a little bit of that. Yellow is going to affect the sun and the lightness. And you can see what it's doing with the trees, right? If you look at that, you can see how the trees are highlighting. But we're going to do that so we can create that. See how that glow comes off of her hair? We want to use that as well. The green should actually be for the things in the background. If I pull that up, you can see a little bit of that is affected with the greens, but not too much. It's not doing too much with that. Siren may be for the sky a little bit. You can see how that sky will lighten up a little bit more. We'll pull that. And then this blue will also affect the sky and the whiteness of the actual photo as well. So the next thing we want to do is we want to lift some shadows, right? Oh, we got brightness in here. So let's go back to this one here. And we're looking at shadows. We're going to lift up some shadows and that's going to play a big part. Now, if I start to pull up the contrast, watch what it does. The contrast does help me a lot here. But what I want to do is I want to lighten up that sweater. We're going to do that with some, we're going to actually do that with a layer. So right now, if I push the white, we can see what the white actually does. But it also affects the sky as well, right? So what we're going to do with this is before is I'm going to, now some people, let me just show you this. Some people never work on the background layer. They'll treat the background layer as a layer that that you don't work on. But if you're doing black and white will always be on the background layer. If you use a preset from Capture One, it will tell you that it will not apply the black and white unless it's on the base layer. But this one, any kind of black and white that you want to do, for instance, if I go back and let's turn off the black and white, which means the colors are going to be ridiculous, right, of what's going on here. So we go back into here. If I go ahead and create a new fill layer and decide that I want to convert this to black and white, it's going to convert it back down to the base. Right, it's going to convert it at the base. So if I turn this off, it's still black and white, you see, because it goes to the base of it. So I just want you to know that. So we'll go in this layer here and I'm going to call this layer lightened sweater. So when we do that, now what we're going to do is we're on this layer, let's turn it on, let's pump up the whites. And we're going to see what we get just by pumping up the whites of this here. Okay, so that's been pumped up. Let's do some brightness. I'm looking for what's in the middle of that sweater. We're looking at that right there. We're going to take the contrast. We can pump up the contrast and really get more white that we want. So what I'm looking at is that I say, okay, that seems to work. So what I want to do is I'm going to go to this layer. If I hit M, you can see that's been selected completely. Now, I can do a couple things. I can try to do what we call a luminosity mask to actually mask this, but it'll actually mask the sky or anything that's light with it. So we're gonna right click on here and tell it to clear the mask. Now, none of that has been applied. I'm gonna hit B for my brush, and I'm gonna go ahead and make sure this is about 69%. And we're gonna go into this and we're going to hit M so I can see what I'm doing. And I'm gonna paint it on, right, in the area that I want it to be on. I do not necessarily want it to be on the arm because that's being lit up already. or it's lightened already, I want it to be on the areas that are not as bright. And the reason I do it on a layer is because by it being on a layer, I can do it as strong as I want to, and then I can lower the opacity, right? So I can make this as strong as I need to make it, and then turn around and lower the opacity. So we hit that there, and we hit M. So you can see that's coming up. Now that's a little bit more lighter than what it is over here, but watch this. As I just start to dial down the opacity, I can pretty much get a good match by dialing down the opacity of that to where it's kind of even, right? I don't want to do anything with lighting this up, because if I go ahead and do this, you'll see that's going to become too light. It's going to, well, you know what? Let's go ahead and do it. But it's going to, it defeats the purpose to do that. So let's go ahead and undo that. So now we got this kind of matching that the way I want it to match, and we'll leave it that way. The next thing we're going to do is go ahead and hit the P key to get the loop thing, and I can look in here, and I really like a freckles. And we got some. Now, I'm not going to take this into Photoshop. Removing that hair that's coming across the face from right there is difficult inside of this program, or removing it from the eye. I'm not necessarily caring about that hair that's in the eye because it's short moving with the wind. But there are some strands that I would like to really bring in and hone in. And I'd have to bring this in either something like Affinity Photo or Photoshop to correct that. And especially this one right here with that hair there. But we're not going to concentrate on that right now. We're just going to do this with the black and white. So now we go back to the base layer. And being that I have to do everything on the base layer anyway for the black and white, let me go ahead and play with this. So I can lift up the blacks, and that'll bring up more of the skirt. Now, again, if that's too much, then I'm bringing up, because it's bringing up everything. You see how I lighten up the hair? We can do that. And again, now I can go to the, I can do it a couple ways. I can do that, and then I can go back and hit this right here as I move this over of the area that you're seeing. You see that's really close to the base. So let's go ahead and click the mid-tone to protect that. And I'm going to lift this up like this, and I'm going to bring it over. That's going to move the black point, but it's going to let me kind of crush the black and actually get some move that black point so I don't have any clipping in that area. And I could actually do that too with this point here and just bring that over, right? Because it'll start at a different point. So we're actually doing the same thing with the whites. And then if I wanted to bring down some of the blacks right here, I can do that. I'm getting that kind of that S curve. I'm getting a better look that I had before. Let's pull this down a little bit more like this. I'm going to what looks good with the eye. And on top of that, let's lift up the blacks down here. So we're going to go with what looks, if I put that back, you can see how dark that is. So we're going to push up the blacks. Again, we're looking at what looks good to the eye. And I'm going to go ahead and push this in about right here. That looks pretty good with the black there. I like the glow we're getting from the sunlight that's hitting their hair. That's really pretty cool. Now the brights will brighten up the midtones if I hit that, but I can also darken the midtones. But what I want to do is with that is I want to create another layer, another fill layer, and I'm going to call this midtones. And when I'm doing this with the midtones, if I decide to pull up the brightness, I like what it's doing. Let's see what it does with darkness. We're going to pull up the brightness of this, but we're going to feather it by using a gradient. So we're going to hit this here, and if I hit my M key, you can see everything is selected. But now we're going to pull up like this, then we're going to have it gradually fade off as it comes to the top. Now you can see just that part down there has been lightened and not too much of the other one. Now if it's too much, what I can actually do is if I hit my M key, if I want to kind of, I'm going to hit the B brush key. Now what this will do is rasterize it. It'll take the gradient to where I can't use a gradient for this layer anymore. But I'm going to rasterize it because I don't want it to come in strong. So now I can do it a couple ways before I do that. If I take this off and I wanted to bring some of it down, I could just lower the opacity, right? And that would gradually come in. But I like what the what's doing in the other parts of it. Another way of doing that would be hit the M key, hit the E key for the erase. when I start moving over this, I want to make sure that I'm not doing it at 100%. It's going to tell me that I'm rasterizing this layer, which is fine. So when I click on it, it's going to rasterize it, and I can no longer use that gradient the way it's being used right now, and that's fine. We'll go ahead and rasterize it, and then I'll just do like this, and I can gradually take it off in the areas that I want it to be. It'll still be there, but I can pinpoint it a little bit more of where I want that to not be as strong with the lighting, right? And it'll be strong everywhere else. And I can still lower the opacity to take care of a little bit more of it, right? So we got that taken care of like that. If I take this off, now you can see what I got. If I take it off, watch this. See, now it's lit up, and I did a pretty good job of what I wanted to have on there. And so now we're going to add some clarity to this. And clarity is like contrast on steroids. We're going to push up the clarity. There's no reason to push up the structure. There's no edges or anything I'm trying to make sharp. If I hit this right here, we want to make sure that it's got it sharp in there. And it looks pretty good. It really does look good. So we're going to push up a little bit more clarity with this. And because now I'm pushing up the clarity, you see I'm on the mid-tone level. So it's really affecting down here and not necessarily up there. So you have to pay attention to the layer that you're on. Let me not push that up. I want to go back down to the background layer, and I want to use clarity. And now you're going to see it jump all over the photo when I push this clarity up. So now we got it looking a little bit better. So that looks really, really good. So now we got a good definition. Looking at that, and the background is pretty soft. We got the sun off of the water with the reflections, and it looks pretty good. There's no reason for me to pump up the structure. We go back to vignetting. I can go ahead and lower this vignette like this, so you can see what I'm doing there. But I have to be careful because it'll put a halo over it, right? And I don't want that halo. So I want to do it probably maybe about a quarter of a stop. About 25 is a quarter of a stop. 24, 25, 30, 26. That's fine. We'll use that on the background layer. And then what we'll do is I'll go into the sharpening of this here. And I'm going to sharpen it. It starts off at 180, but we're going to sharpen it some more. I love sharpening black and white photos. There we go. That looks very detailed and very sharpened. We're going to raise the radius up a little bit. There's no noise reduction or anything to take out. Grain is going to be the issue. So let's go in, let's zoom into this. You hold your H key down and drag it around. So we got this grain. We have this sharp photo. But I want to add some grain into it because grain just looks good on black and white. Now, fine grain, if I pump this up, you'll see how it looks. It doesn't look bad, but it's fine grain. On black and whites, you kind of want that harsh grain. So some people use Silver Rich. If I push that up, watch what it does. You can really see it in the, you can see it in the texture of things. So that really gives you that harsh look if you want to do that. And you can play with the granularity by moving that up and moving it down. You can play around with that as well and get and kind of get a look that you want. But I'm not going to use that one there. You also have soft grain. You can push that up and it'll look pretty much the same. And you'll see a lot of black and whites with this. So that will give you that look. But I want to use, and then you have cubic grain. I'm just going through all of them so you can see how they look with those settings. I actually like what cubic, like what this one looks like here. The one that I normally go with is this tabular. That's the one I like the most. So we're going to go with that, and we're going to pull this down from not 41. We're going to go 36, and we got that there. And if we hit this here, that is the photo. And so if I go ahead and hold down my Alt key and click on this, this is what we started with this colored photo right here. And with nothing being applied, and then as we apply it, this is what we got out of here. Now, we're not done. There's still a couple more things that I want to do. I'm going to go back into this photo here, and I'm going to lift the shadows up a little bit more to bring out a little bit more of that photo. Right? There we go. We lift the shadows a little bit more. We can take the whites. If I take the whites down, you'll see what it does to it. We're going to push the whites up a little bit more for that. And again, we got brightness. Now this is putting it on everything. If I do brightness, if I pull the brightness down, it's darker. If I push the brightness, it really represents that kind of that light and day. And of course, I don't want to touch the exposure. I can lift the exposure and do this, but I don't want it to be a kind of harsh photo. That is the look that I want to have on there. And that actually works. Now, if I wanted to play around with shadows, because you see the sun is coming from here, but you see there's a shadow over here. And if you notice, what I was using was, I'm actually using a flash, right, to kind of compensate to be fill in, because she's directly, the sun is behind her. And if I don't have the flash and fire that flash, you can see I'm shooting at 1/6500 of a second. But if I don't fire the flash as well, she would be almost in total silhouette and she'd have the raccoon eyes. So I am using flash to light that up. So if I wanted to actually bring in a little bit more darkness to simulate that, to make this dark over here with that, and say she's being lit up by the sun, that's a trick that we can do. We'll go ahead and right click over here. I'll just call this dark shadow, right? And what I'll do with that is I'll go here. We're gonna go to the luma curve. I wanna be in this area here, which is the midtone. So I'm gonna take the midtone of this and I'm gonna pull it way down like this, right? And then I'm just gonna hit my L key to get my gradient. And I want this to kind of come up this way like this. And as I apply that, you can see what is actually hitting with that. So let's do this right here. We can see what that's actually hitting. And if we take that off, now let's take this off here. You see that's lightened. Now we got some darkness and it's a little bit too much. So we'll just walk back the layer a tad bit. I like what we got here. We still got some darkness there. We still got some shadows that are showing. So that is that photo. And I'm going to bring you more tutorials like this using Capture One. So if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe, and I'm going to bring you more tutorials like this. Thanks for watching.